In this lesson, we will focus on one of the key lessons of computer networks, network cabling. Network cabling is the physical connections of the nodes. There are various of network cables and connectors are used for these purposes. This is the physical layer of OSI model, in other words, layer 1. The data is transferred over these mediums with electrical signals or lights. According to the need of the network, there are various network cable types. The main network cable types are copper twisted pair, fiber optic cable, coaxial and serial cables. You can see each of these cable types on the screen, where we use these cables or where we plug them. Here is a switch and its interfaces. We plug network cables on these ports. These ports are the ports for copper twisted pair cables. Here are some examples of cabling both with copper and fiber optic cables. There are a lot of cables in a large network, so different standardizations are used to manage them. Documentation, labeling, cable organizations are some of these standardizations. Beside cables, connectors are also very important in computer networking cabling. To terminate the cables, we need connectors. What is a connector in network cabling, basically? A connector is a device that terminates a segment of cabling or provides an entry point for network devices. There are various connectors used in network cabling. Some of them are twisted pair connector, RJ45, coaxial cable connector, BNC, and different fiber optic connectors like SC, ST, LC, and FC. According to the need in the network, one of these connectors is used. Here is one of the well-known connectors, RJ45. The long form of it is registered, JAC45. It is also known as Ethernet connector. The color codes on these connectors are given on the screen. On copper cables twisted pair cables, there are 8 lines. Each of them has a color code. When you crimp a connector to a cable, these color codes are important. They need to be in correct order. By the way, what is crimping and what is crimping tool in networking? When you connect connector to the cable, this is crimping. And the tool that helps this process is called crimping tool. There are various types of crimping tools used by network technicians. On the screen, there is an example of crimping tools. The first cable type that we will focus is copper twisted pair cable. There are 2 types of copper twisted pair cables. These are UTP, unshielded twisted pair, and STP, shielded twisted pair. Let's start with UTP. UTP is the twisted pair type, which has no shield over the pairs. There are 4 pairs in this cable type. UTP cables transmit data via electrical signals. These signals are converted to zeros and ones. They are used for short distances like home networks, office networks. UTP cables can be affected by electromagnetic interference. The pairs are twisted to reduce crosstalk and electromagnetic interference. Another copper twisted pair type is STP, shielded twisted pair. Again, there are 4 pairs in these cables, but there is also a shield over the pairs. STP cables are less prone to noise. They support higher speeds. They are heavy and costly than UTP. And an extra ground is needed for this type of cable. STP is used in the locations more prone to interference. There are different types of UTP and STP cables, like Category 5, Category 6, Category 7, Category 8, etc. On the screen, you can see the detailed properties of these copper twisted pair cables. Let's compare these cable types, category cables. If we make an analogy about these category cables, Cat5 is like a bicycle, Cat5E is like a car, Cat6 is like a train, Cat6A is like a fast train, Cat7 is like a plane, and lastly, Cat8 is like a rocket. The fastest one is Cat8 for today. We use some units for speed measurement in networking. As you know, bits are zeros and ones, and 8 bits are equal to 1 byte. We use bits per second to measure data transfer speed. It is the amount of bits transferred in a single second. There are larger units like kilobits per second, megabits per second, gigabits per second, terabits per second. Ethernet is the common technology for connecting devices in a wired network. There are different standards of Ethernet. It supports different types of cables. Here, there is a term called base T. It means baseband signaling, twisted pair. Ethernet is the simplest one. It is 10 base T with the speed 10 megabits per second. Fast Ethernet is the one which is also called as 100 base T. It supports 100 megabits per second. Gigabit Ethernet is the other one called also as 1000 base T. It supports 1000 megabits per second. The last one is 10 gigabit Ethernet, 10,000 base T. It supports 10,000 megabits per second. Here is a comparison of these four standards. There is also an analogy to compare their speed. Here, Ethernet is like a turtle. It is slow. Fast Ethernet is like a monkey. It has a mid-level speed. Gigabit Ethernet is fast, like a German Shepherd. And 10 gigabit Ethernet is the fastest, like a cheetah. The standard name of these standards are also given on the screen. Ethernet standard is 802.3i. Fast Ethernet standard is 802.3u. Gigabit Ethernet standard is 802.3ab. And 10 gigabit Ethernet is 802.3an. Here is also a long list of these standards. I will not explain all of them here because this is too much details. And this is also not the full list of these standards. There are more than this. When we connect different devices with copper cables, different devices need different port types. These types are MDI or MDI-X. The transmit and receive pins are in different order for these MDI and MDI-X. According to these types, we use different types of cables to match the transmit and receive pins. So we have two different cable types according to the connector connections at the end of the cables. One of them is straight through cable, the other is crossover cable. A straight through cable is a type of cable used to connect different types of devices. Here are the TX and RX pin locations in the network devices. Here we can say that router, PC, and server are similar devices. Switch is different device because their TX and RX pins are all different. A crossover cable is a cable used to connect similar devices. The order of pins are different in crossover cable. This is used to match transmit-receive pins of both end. Think about that. If you connect similar devices, their pins are in the same order. So, to connect TX and RX, you need to cross over the connection. This is why we use crossover cable. Another type according to the pin difference is rollover cable. A rollover cable is a cable that is used to connect a computer terminal to a router's console port. As you can see, the pins at one end is the opposite of the other end. This is a connection list that shows when we use straight-through cable and crossover cable. According to this list, we should use straight-through cable if we are connecting a switch to a router or a switch to a PC. We should use crossover cable if we are connecting a switch to another switch, a router to another router, or PC to a router. As we have mentioned before, there are MDI and MDI-X interfaces on the network devices. MDI-X is the crossover version of MDI. In a device, one of these ports, or two of them, can be used. For example, on this device, uplink port is MDI, and other ports are MDI-X. According to these types, we determine the used cable type, straight through or crossover cables. And here, let's also show this with a visual. Here, the transmitting 1 and 2 pins on an MDI device go to the receiving pins 1 and 2 on an MDI-X device via a straight-through cable. Similarly, the receiving 3 and 6 pins on an MDI device go to the transmitting 3 and 6 pins on an MDI-X device. Here, the MDI-X port eliminates the need for a crossover cable. This information is important, but in today's networks, there is no need for this, because there is a mechanism which can adjust the pins at the other end automatically. And you do not need to determine a cable type manually anymore. The name of this mechanism is AutoMDIX. It automatically detects neighbors' transmitting pins and adjusts own pins. It automatically chooses the MDI or MDIX configuration to properly match the other end of the link. So, it is not important anymore that you are using straight through or crossover cables. Lastly, let's talk about transmission modes in computer networking. there are three transmission modes. These are simplex, half duplex, and full duplex. In simplex mode, only one end can send only one direction. In half duplex mode, only one end can send data at a time. In full duplex mode, both end devices can send data at a time. This is the end of our lesson. Now let's test what we have learned. What is the name of Ethernet UTP cable connector? MTP, SC, LC, RJ, 45, or BNC? The answer is RJ45 connector has four twisted pairs, provide 10,000 megabits per second speed, named also as 802.3AN. What is this standard? Ethernet, fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet, 10 gigabit Ethernet, none of them. The answer is 10 gigabit Ethernet. Which one is the commonly used unit of measurement for information speed in the communication of data? Bits per second, bytes per second, cost per second, data per second, or none of them? The answer is bits per second. Which connections need straight through cable? Switch, router, 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 switch, switch, PC, switch, or PC, router. The answers are A and D, switch to router, and PC to switch connections. Which mechanism automatically adjusts cable pins at the other end and bypass determining cable types manually? PoE, crossover, MDI-X, MDI, and auto MDI-X. The answer is auto MDI-X. It is over. You can continue with the second part of network cabling, fiber optic cables. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Good luck.